There's a number of reasons why your Bitrise build might fail, and troubleshooting can be a difficult experience.
There are some things, however, that you can do to make it a little easier. In this video, we'll talk about how to try and debug your build on your own machine before doing anything else. Debugging a Bitrise build on your own machine needs two things: a full clean Git clone of your Bitrise app's repository and the Bitrise CLI to run a build locally. Running a local build with a clean repository is especially useful if you previously managed to build your app locally and then the build fell down Bitrise. That happens because usually you don't run local builds with a clean repository. Your repo can contain uncommitted or gitignore files that nevertheless are necessary for the build to succeed, but aren't present in the online repo, therefore Bitrise has no access to them. So, before anything else, let's get a clean repo. Create a new directory for your app, and clone the content of your online Git repository in that directory, then check out the branch you want to test. Once you're done, it's time to test the app. Download the bitrise.yaml file from bitrise.io. Open the app on the website, go to Workflows, then click the bitrise.yaml tab. Click Download Currently Saved Config, and save the file in the new clean repository on your own machine. Next, you'll need the Bitrise CLI. If you don't have it, you have two ways to install it. You can open a bash shell and use this call command. Once the download is complete, you need to make the binary executable with the following command. Alternatively, if you're on a Mac, you can use homebrew. Open the terminal and enter this command. Once the CLI is up and running, navigate to your clean repos directory in your bash shell or terminal, and use the bitrise run command with the name of the workflow that you want to test. So, if you want to run a build with a primary workflow, you'll need to run bitrise run primary. If this build succeeds, but your bitrise build still fails, check the tool versions that you used. It's possible that your app requires either an older or a newer version than what is installed on our virtual machines. You can find out the pre-installed tools and their versions from our system reports on GitHub, link is on the screen. It's always worth checking your code signing settings too. For example, in the case of an iOS app, make sure you uploaded the correct files to Bitrise. We very much hope that this video helps you too. If it did, don't hesitate to like and subscribe. See you in the next one.